And in business, the Public Interest and Accountability Committee has expressed satisfaction over ongoing road projects funded by oil revenue in the Greater Accra region. The committee is presently inspecting some projects, including the Flower Pot motorway flyover at Spintex. The move is to ensure that funds from the annual budget funding amount drawn from the sale of crude oil by the country is judicially used for its intended purposes. Here's more.
It emerged that the finance ministry disbursed some 3.6 million cedis into the construction of the flyover from the APFA account in 2019. The vice chairman of the committee, Nasir, expressed worry that an insignificant amount has been allocated from the oil resources considering the cost of the entire project.
Now, our problem with that particular project is that it means that we can't really point to a significant impact of the oil money on that project. And when we are mentioning projects that oil money should go into, it is too insignificant for us to say that oil money has gone into this. Even though we will see the quantum as 3 point something million, in terms of the total project cost, that is too insignificant, almost negligible.
Would you suggest that they add more to it?
Now, what we are saying, and PIAC has always advocated, is that we commit significant amount of oil money into legacy projects. So if we consider the flyover as an important and a project and a priority to us, let us commit as much oil money as possible to it so that significantly we can point to it as an oil project, right?
The team also inspected the 1.5 kilometers Accra power line stretch in the Linkwantana Madina municipality, which was completed in 2018.
We need to work on our maintenance and ensure that where there are potholes, we act as fast as possible to ensure that the potholes don't develop into manholes. Forgive me for using the word manholes. But we do have some few potholes that we are hoping that the assembly will take into consideration and ensure that whoever is doing maintenance here should ensure that all the potholes are done with. And that way we can actually say that there is value for the oil money that has been applied here. Interestingly, I also live just a few meters away from here. I never knew this was an oil-funded project, actually. But today, I am being told that over 90% of the project cost that went into this particular road was actually coming from oil money. And to the extent that I'm a member of the committee, I think for this particular project, I'm extremely happy.
Officials from the Department of Urban Roads who took the team on the road inspection expressed satisfaction with the project.